Ready?
Yeah. Go for it.
Welcome to my presentation. Today we will be talking about risk and disadvantages of a computing company not having secure software on the company and its customers. I'll also be talking about penalties that a company or an employees will have to deal with if they break the Data Protection Act. In the planning of a project, I chose my topic, which was the impact of a company not having secure software. If a company doesn't have secure software, then they will not be able to keep their customers safe from them losing their details. When I started writing my project, I started with making the contents page of the bibliography, writing the discussion, and I moved on to doing the abstract, the introduction, and the conclusion before I finished it. A big risk that companies will face would be that they accidentally leak information, whether it be from a hacker or if they just person went outside the company, accidentally lost it because of an external drive. They would have to pay a fine for the Data Protection Act, and it could be up to £500,000. Another risk would be that if their system is not secure, a hacker could access their system, install viruses, corrupt data, and delete their data. This would cause a lot of problems for the company. It would be very expensive to fix. If the company does not keep their system secure from hackers and leak information, people won't want to go back to the company and they won't trust them. So it would give them a bad reputation. If you don't know, the Data Protection Act was made in 1984, it was remade in 1998, and it is to protect their customers from companies who don't have secure software, so it will not be their fault if they lose their data, so it would be companies. During the presentation I've talked about the Data Protection Act, I've talked about the risks and disadvantages that companies can face with not having their software secure. Any questions?
I do, yeah. What is secure software?
Secure software is software that can protect it's not easily hacked into by people outside the company. So if a hacker that's inexperienced tries to hack into it, they most likely won't be able to.
And are you suggesting all pieces of software that an organisation has should be secure?
Yeah, so if one piece of software isn't secure, then that is a gateway into the company that hackers get into through.
Okay, and do you know any particular methods of making software secure?
Well, having an antivirus and a firewall is one way of keeping your system secure. Because if you don't have antivirus, then any kind of virus can get in. They wouldn't even need a Trojan.
And then you said firewall as well?
Yeah, so the firewall just protects any unwanted traffic coming into the system, and also protects from DDoS attacks.
Okay. Right, I'm happy with that. Thanks, Jamie.